think the only Razi usually checklist. Move all usually copies of. He has two copies of this. Seem pretty axed in them. After his. And that's the big thing about the Eldrazi deck, is a lot of these palace with things traders. So after they get their palace out, they magic they'll drop two because pretty unfortunate. And it's worth noting. Here's with the win. Can probably play a land next turn. Gonna float the mana. Excellent. Down two. Like we can't really see that Badlands. That. Like as the sunlight picks. Well, the mimic is terribly strong. Every deck. I assume naming it. I don't think I've ever. Gotta reshape. Power comes into the red zone. Blood. Down to 7. Got attack for 5 next turn. Soul land. Reality smash. That'll hurt a lot. Doesn't look like it actually hurt them. A life from the not a maverick. He looks like he's on punishing aggro low, punishing low, punishing blue. I've heard it called tons of them. Yeah, like I said, the chalice I guess just doesn't matter at all because they on the stack with the stack that we just abrupt decay. You don't really want to abrupt decay matter reshaper because goods. I don't hate going up the mimic. He has another mimic. Or aggro strategy. Awesome link. Confidant down. Healthy life. Life soul's being pressured. Oh. It's gonna hurt him a lot. Play Confidant. Get back in this. But it looks like Lane's down to one card. He's running fast pretty quick. Pick off the big threats of these abrupt decay. Falls on really. Jason could be looking in pretty good shape. Especially if he ends up with the Punishing Fire combo at any. I think that combo is very. Well, dudes, Eldrazi play. Once again, not very terribly. It could be okay. We have an endless. Yeah, it's. Mimic becomes a. What's worth noting, it might be abrupt decay. Unless one does die to abrupt. But he's that attack for 9 here. The mimic doesn't like the worst world, especially if you have some other. That matter reshape. Pretty much always the threat you want to kill the least. Gonna end up getting the most. Kind of abrupt decay, paid 3. Got the mimic. Back from full 9. And looks like it's gonna get back Jason. Fall land. kind of fixing is pretty good. Is Taiga Bayou Scream. He has all his colors. I know. He does have all his colors. There's not terribly many. He does have the man. Tells them. Got a confidant still. Still doesn't feel. Maybe it's worth playing just to off the matter reshaper. But block and not going to attack with matter reshaper. Or his endless one. Fight some damage. Got a green. I can grab, you know, hopefully something bigger than the. Right now, knight would only be a 3-3. A 6-6. Probably wanted to honestly be a 7-7. Profitably. He's kind of in a tough spot. Yeah, you see the dark confidence. He has two greens. Wow. Yeah, now I have to correct what I said at the beginning. He does not have like Gaddock Tiger. Aggro Loam instead of Maverick. Scavenging is good. No, he does have a Teak main. He does. So, I mean, that would hurt his. It's still pretty good against all draws. Down to four. Have to do something. Although it looks like Lane doesn't have that much gas. There's the Abrupt Decay for the Endless One. You could see Jason begin to stabilize here. Especially, you know, with that Wasteland in the graveyard. I think he's away from the. Maybe that's just. Pardon, he has. Yeah, I think it is alive. Hitting Wasteland, start Wasteland. Have to get that. Have to get him. Bigger creep. Reality Smash. God, even Thought Knot's here. He could snipe the. Life from the. From his hand. Before he even gets to play it and start combo on. The Life and Loam combo is actually very. Thorn of Amethyst. Oh no, that's the. I think that's the. Tomb of the Spirit Dragon. That's so he paid two mana. Control. Oh, that played in stand actually right before. Fuzzy deck. So it's interesting to see. I don't know if that's the typical thing for Eldrazi now. I haven't really kept up with it. But from what I've seen, that's pretty nonsense. Looks like he's. Yeah, okay, so he's green signing for two. He paid extra one. I would not be surprised to see him. That shuts down pretty much everything scary out of his deck. Oh no, he's just going to go ahead and grab them. Think. Not quite bigger than his other dudes. I don't know. I really want to grab Teak. Shuts down everything. All his endless shuts down. No, it doesn't shut down. I think it's non. Wow, that's so. But only hurt. Have to grab. Sorry to you, viewer. See me play. I play miracles, and so I do. Or X cost creatures. On every form, X amount of thing I do, they can leave soon. Creatures too. I don't think it does, which makes it very much much worse in this matchup. And you probably on the make knight as big as possible. He has a knight. He can start stacking some grove, try to dredge into fires, punishing fire. Chances are pretty high he can hit one off. Starts dredging. I think he really first wants to start getting that. Might really. see what Lane's got. Oh, that's ancient. Doom. Warping whale paying me. Burn. A 1-1. Yeah, he's gonna make a 1-1. Life off these. Oh no, it's just a chalice. It matters a lot because it shuts down that life from the combo and it shuts down punishing fire. That one he cares a lot about. He drew, which is much worse than I originally thought it is. Once again, also gets countered by chalice. That chalice for two is very strong. I think Lane probably would have put his first chalice on two. Aggro loam. Chalice on two is much, much, much. If he wants to go ahead and fire off that green. Try for the life, make chalice on two. Attic Teague also gets killed. I think if he remembers it, the not sure. Attic in the grave, averaging it. Ravaging Ooze. But I think, oh, it seems height is just. Bear in mind, Aggro Loam. The Merit Leash combo. Like he just grabbed the first part of it. That seems like a good way to end this game very quickly. Behind. Now has Knight ready to go ahead and activate. I actually don't like dredging. Hit Dark Depths. You have no way to. Also, don't have. I have many. Actually, flyers. Flies. Have one. Like he's at fuck out of him. Still in there. Head and grabs. That online. I mean, this is what you see a lot out of the. Had a very powerful start, but as Aggro Loam is not the deck that really. Chalice and really having that much. I'd get there. That Chalice on one. Have this hand. Like, you really do see this a lot with the Eldrazi. Well, it's not as, I think, oppressively powerful as it was in Modern. Legacy, it's, decks are much more powerful stars. Here, the Merit Leash getting in red zone. Finish up game one. Go ahead and move to sideboards. We'll see if Lane has an answer to the Merit Leash token in the sideboards. As I said, like, Eldrazi, powerful start. Didn't quite see any. Thoughtnot Seers, Reality Smashers, and creatures to go ahead and finish that game. Aggro Loam, go ahead and out game one after a very scary start. Let's see what we got on the sideboard. Jason Drinkard on. Got a Canonist, a Reclamation, Oak, Clan of the Void, Alia, Guardian, Rook Relentless, a Maelstrom Pulse, two Thoughtseize, a Toxic Dave, Water Game. I suspect we'll see Reclamation. That card seems very. Cards that are a Grook Relentless actually seems okay. It produces blocker every time. Blockers that profitably block. Well, they don't profitably block, but trade. You know, it's a token trade. But I do kind of like Grook Relentless. You see, Jason. 4 mana Planeswalk. I think Grook Relentless. Maelstrom Pulse, I suspect, will also come in. Kills things. Problems that Jason might want. And a lot of lanes threats are very redundant. A lot of four of, so there's a good chance he'll see something. So there's a good chance Maelstrom Pulse can get a 2. Toxic Deluge, I also suspect, very good. Same. K5 life. And Bithing Needle might be okay if you don't have that many bringers. Eye of Ugin, if you're scared of that late game. He has a lot of weight. Not be the best, but it seems at least justifiable. Especially because you can take out things. I suspect Chalice of the Void are going to come out because. So he has a lot of outs. On lane side, got a Ratchet Bomb, a Cursed Totem, World Break, Force Field, Number, Warping Wind, Sail Out of the Void, Full Contort, Full Worlds, and a Hammerback World. Got a pretty spicy sideboard. Pretty cute cards. I think Winter Orb is fantastic. Sail Out of the Void, I think, is. Happened to it.
I don't know, it's just
Hear me? Okay. Anyway. Okay. First Totem could be okay. Averaging a screwing up the combo, that's pretty bad. So, first totem. Force Field stops the Merit Lage. I think that definitely can. World Breaker seems. Locks pretty much. Numbers probably. Knights kill out of the problem. Out of the aggro load. I think Lane has a lot of ends here. First totem, World Breaker. Probably want the late. Crucible Worlds, they play the Waste box of Life in the Low. Go ahead and bring back your lands. Alright. Like the players are about done sideboarding. You know what's interesting is, you know, neither one of these decks play blue. That's something worth noting about the common misconception that you have to play blue. Do not think that's really actually true. I mean, you see Eldrazi is doing well. You see Agraloma deck that doesn't play blue doing well. But we also have other decks like Death and Taxes, Elves. A lot of people are like, you know, Legacy. Like any blue dual lands and have that big misconception about what. I think that really, I mean, is evident. The Legacy format, I think, is very healthy. Large quantity of Eldrazi showing up, but in a lot of the for tournaments, you still have very varied top eights. Look at any of the classics, the last open. Very rarely two copies of this deck in a top eight. And I think that's almost the definition of a very healthy format. Lots of decks. Very big variety of strategies. Aggro combo's very good. Spells a hell of a card. Roll as miracles. Weird combo aggro like elves. All kinds of stuff. And we see Lane did bring in Leyline of the Void. I definitely don't hate that at all. Got to turn one City of Traders for it. Now, playing your City of Traders as your first land doesn't feel, especially when it gets a wasteland. There's a good chance that was his only. Yep, simply mimic. Go ahead and get in. Plus, maybe yeah, we see him second land. He does have the Crucible of Worlds, so he could bring it back later if he. Just... The hand keeps him have the turn. Taiga and throw back. Second lane did pick up a copy of Cavern of Soul. Probably want to go ahead and draw Soul Land. Don't have to worry about. The bright side, that Wasteland is exiled. Oh wow, he's found another one. Looks like Jason does have a life in one. And a Punishing Fire that's not going to work. Prove he hasn't. This Mimic just might get there. He's getting in for a lot of damage. Worst comes to worst, Jason can kill it with a Punishing Fire. That doesn't feel. I don't think that's really what you want to be using. Elaine pick up another copy of Cavern of Soul. Oh, once again, no one drops in his hand. Let's go ahead and decide to fire off the Punishing Fire at the Mimic. But he has no one drops. He needs a Soul Land, and he's. Right. Copy of Catacomb. Draws the second crew. Play a mim an in one for wow. XL Drazi being 1/1 is not doesn't feel terribly good. Jason go ahead and fire a Punishing Fire. Having none of that. Punishing Fire is much less good against the no, without that, you can snipe up. Battery shape. Thought not if you play, bring back again, kill most of their creatures. Fire combo. Had to use one on a pick, one on an endless one, and that's all. Jason picked up his Riot Arbor, normally used. Here, played on 5. Play Chalice on 0. I'm not sure why Chalice is still. Does not. Aggro Loam, once again, Aggro Loam is a Chalice deck. Hard. Oh, not see. Adoresh. Cards off screen. The Chalice and Zero, probably not going to. Thoughts he's. A whole lot of action, so had a lot of time to go ahead and draw a Soul Land, pick up a copy of that makes later. You're moving, have to hope. He's... I don't know. After Jason seen two, go ahead and playing all your lands out because. Not many ways. Card's gonna stay a 2/2. It's not gonna get bigger, but it can search up ways. Looks like he picked up the fourth Cavern of Souls. Well, that casts the Crucible of Worlds. That'll get lands back, so. Searching up Wasteland with Light isn't out. Find an answer. Has. I assume he has that Force Field in here. That should be a castable now. That'll be pretty. As long as Jason doesn't have the. This is where you see Jason not drawing any more removal. Crop Decay, he probably really go ahead and Crucible shoot. Crop Decay, that'll give him a turn. Lane has to place for that of Crucible. So he can play a Soul Land. Then plays a that once S A activate. Apparently it does not have haste. Not gonna die this turn. See what Jason wants to grab with this night activation. Does look like he's gonna go for it, but about that. Like I said, Lane's hand was very good. He just managed to plant his crucible, replay all his land. Once he has a lot of mana, a lot of what Lane is powerful against. I think Argalom's been of its set of abrupt decays. A lot of time before. A lot of it out of. Like, in fact, apparently he's from Doom. Goes in and shoots another Abrupt Decay off at the crew. It really cost him because it is very, very good against Merit Lage. Definitely has. He has the Cursed Totem in his hand. Shut down Knight. Play it. Bond by grabbing the Merit Lage. Definitely has. Jason's been through three Abrupt Decays. One left they grab. Force Filter instant. Grab another land. At least another attacker. You know, you get three attackers, get in for damage a turn. Block. Actually, he'll get. Force Field will be powerful here. Daddy late. I think one of the only. And I think. Lage token is pretty peculiar. It was like a $1 token. Oh, around 10. Old snap. Build a day, legacy. Combos banned in modern, I assure you, would probably be played. Combos are very powerful. Creatures that one shot your opponent are very typically very powerful. By Seal Cold. You can really get that. Emrakul, leave your opponent at 5. That matters a lot of the time. Has lost multiple. Not high chance, especially after they stack 6. Sneak attack in an Emrakul, never draw anything else. Your opponent can't draw out of it. 5 life. Merit Lage doesn't give you that option. It's take 20. Card is. If Thought Knot's at Liliana, so the Thought die. Life not accomplished. Much Grove also not accomplished. With a Thought Knot now on the. Have a hard time swinging. Was on blocking dude, but the force field is definitely going to could see a big board. Merit Lage. Still an interesting. Hundreds of dollars card. One of the many cards printed. That's the air a price tag high. Here we see why though. The card's very strong. Played a lot in EDH, but seen it a little more and more in Legacy now. Showing what it can do here. Stopping an average of 19 damage a turn. about that, because he does only have 13 turns until the mirror actually kills him. Death on his blocker, Merit Lage's blocker, so Jason's defense is not something that's profitable anymore. Stabilize. I assume he probably just went. Yeah. The rest of it's here we see Ultra Bolt. Blockers. Probably the top deck here. Aggro Loam. But after turn, Aggro Loam can often like life in the loam. Draw steps because they accomplish a lot. Life in the loam. Microphone. Microphone. Alright. Microphone's cutting out a lot. That you got. All right. Oh. Well,
struggle here for a second. Trying to get the microphone to pick up what I'm saying. Not working. But try. Elaine picked up a third Thought Knotseer. Elshin Pulse looking like a better draw all the time. Battery Shaper. Yep. This one on 5 is going to stop a lot of these attacks tonight. I think is on just search up once. It seems like I don't know if he has another one. Now the Aggro Loam deck can't afford to play. Deck itself does. A lot of those land prison pieces can't afford to jam of, and you're gonna the one copy of the Dark Depths kind of, like one or two play. Full set of wastelands. But life from the loam. Only play two life from the loam. Much less actual lands deck itself. Have a lot of the pieces. Try to be like a Maverick deck combined with lands. It's an interesting concoction. I'm not totally convinced that average on average the better position deck, but being able to like turn one chalice, have like knights as blocker. They'll do a lot of the powerful things. Draws line up. Very good. Looks like Lane had his one land actually that he up for Force Field. You can't activate Force Field until the creature's unlocked. So Jason was able to attack for Merit Lage. Get in when tapped out to play. It is one source that he had up for Force Field. Red Zone. So, that'll be the end of round one. Off loss, Aggro Loam. Lane not quite out of time. Aggro Loam probably much better against Eldrazi than called the matchup. But we did see the Garruk come in. We see Reclamation. did bring in Thoughtseize. I don't know. I kind of like bringing in Maelstrom Pulse. It didn't look like he did. Yeah, it looks like his Thoughtseize.